The Cal State L.A. web platform includes a WYSIWYG, what you see is what you get, editor, which makes it easy to create and edit content without using any programming languages. It includes commonly used editing features found in word processors, as well as additional components specially designed for web content. Links are found on nearly all web pages. The WYSIWYG editor simplifies the process of linking to web pages, files, and email addresses. To link to a web page, in the body field, select the text that you want to link. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Link button. The Link dialog box opens. On the Link Info tab, select the URL option from the link type list. Select the appropriate protocol from the protocol list. In the URL field, enter the web address that you want to link to. To open the link in a new window, on the Target tab of the Link dialog box, select the New Window option from the target list. Click the OK button. To link to a file, in the body field, select the text that you want to link. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Link button. The Link dialog box opens. On the Link Info tab, select the URL option from the link type list. Click the Browse Server button. If a file needs to be uploaded, click the Upload button on the File Browser toolbar. Next, click the Browse button to locate the file to be uploaded. Once the file has been located, double-click on it to select it for upload. To confirm the upload, click the Upload button. In the right pane of the File Browser window, select the file that you want to link to. On the File Browser toolbar, click the Insert File button. The File Browser window closes and the URL field in the Link dialog box is populated with the file path. Click the OK button. To link to an email address, in the body field, select the text that you want to link. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Link button. The Link dialog box opens. On the Link Info tab, select the Email option from the link type list. In the Email Address field, enter the email address of the recipient. To add a subject or body to the email message, enter the desired text in the corresponding fields. Click the OK button. The WYSIWYG editor simplifies the process of uploading images to the web server and adding them to web pages. Web authors should provide alternative text descriptions for all images that they add to a web page. To add an image, in the body field, click where you want to insert the image. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Image button. The Image Properties dialog box opens. Next to the URL field, click the Browse Server button. In the right pane of the File Browser window, select the image that you want to insert. On the File Browser toolbar, click the Insert File button. In the Alternative Text field, enter a brief description of the image. In the Advanced tab of the Image Properties dialog box, set an advisory title for the image. The advisory title can be the same as the alternative text. Click the OK button. Web authors can add videos to web pages by embedding videos that are hosted on YouTube. To add a video, in the body field, click where you want to embed the video. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Add Media button. The Add Media dialog box opens. Copy the URL or embed code from the YouTube video page. Paste it in the URL or embed code field. Click the Submit button. And then click the Submit button. Note that the video displays as a text link in the body field, but will display as an embedded video when the page is saved. Tables are commonly used to organize and present data on a web page. They should not be used for creating page layouts. An important step toward creating an accessible data table is to designate row and/or column headers. To add a table, in the body field, click where you want to insert the table. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Table button. The Table Properties dialog box opens. In the Rows and Columns fields, enter the desired number of rows and columns. Select the appropriate headers option. Set other options as needed. And then click the OK button. The Table Properties dialog box closes, and the table is inserted in the body field. To add content to the table, click in each cell and enter data. Note that a table can be edited or deleted by right-clicking in the table and then selecting the desired option on the shortcut menu. Templates can be used to create different page layouts. They contain text and image placeholders that indicate the places where web authors need to enter their own content. There are a variety of templates that web authors can choose from. To use a template, in the body field, click where you want to insert the template. On the WYSIWYG toolbar, click the Templates button. The Content Templates dialog box opens. If you want the template to replace the contents in the body field, select the Replace Actual Contents checkbox. Otherwise, the template will be inserted at the location of the cursor. Select the template that you want to use. The Content Templates dialog box closes, and the selected template is inserted into the body field. Replace the text and image placeholders with your own content.